Hello, YouTube out there, and hello myself. I'm going to watch this video and see how stupid I am later. Stoic development. I just made a click app called Click Cookie Cutter, which assumes you know what a Python cookie cutter is. It's a scaffolding project templates. So it means that you make a set of folders and files, and you put whatever you want in them, and then you're going to deploy those places with different variables for things like folder name, file name, and the text that's in the files, if that makes any sense. And then Python click, which is a command line interface, and that is a big point for me because I think all apps should have a command line interface so that you can, the original API before web APIs was a command line API. And a lot of apps still have them and they still call them that, like Django and Flask and Pandox built their own command line, which I made a click wrapper for too. Pandox, Pandas, it's funny. I'm using click to make simplified workflow specific command lines so that you can automate those applications your own way faster and simpler. So anyhow, blah blah blah. Let's look at the README. It's a click interface, which is kind of dumb to say. It's click for a cookie cutter, that's what I'm gonna call it. Here's what click does. I'm on my Pixelbook, so I have to run it a little different because I don't have click installed correctly. So you run CLI command line interface .py, and it gives you a description. It's got help commands, so you can run these commands. Let's just run some of them. Install. If you have a machine you haven't installed click and cookie cutter, then you run that and it'll give you a little bit of help. Also in the README there's some commands for installing the requirements, moving some scripts around, and then the config file. So here's a config file. You're just gonna set a path. You're gonna need to change this. I had to use this absolute path because my Pixelbook's not fully set up, and I think one of these apps doesn't support the tilde for the home, so I'd put it in there. Anyway, then you can run list. List shows you your cookie cutters. So there's some of mine, and those are in your cookie cutter folder, which you can move that around. So that's here. Here's those scripts. Push all, pull all, that you need to install on your own folder. The folder can change. That's why they're there, because you may put them in a different folder, depending how you configured cookie cutter. But that's the default location, and it lists the ones that are there. And then you can use them. Before you use them, you might want to run pull, which updates them, goes through all of them and updates, pulls, does a git pull. Okay, now they're up to date. Now you'd use one. Deploy. And when you deploy, I'm gonna put in a one that I know is there's only gonna be one match. So it found, if I just typed in part of the name and it found it, and then you choose an output folder where you want to deploy it to. And now this is cookie cutter running, and it's asking you to enter variables that are defined in your individual cookie cutters. That one deployed, and now it ran a hook that opens Codium editor, but that's not this, that's the hook in the cookie cutter. And I'll just pull that up. So I deployed it to the test folder. You can see there it is. But if you were to run deploy and you had a more than one match for the name you typed in, it asks you the output folder, just like the deploying the one that matched. But now it's going to go through and ask you. So I have a readme templates. Yes, it's going to go ahead and do those. And now there's another match because I typed in cook and I got a bunch named cookie cutter. So there's a shell app. I'm going to say no, debugging a template for cookie cutters. So now as it steps through, you can choose one or however many you want to deploy. So now the readme's in there, and then I pick one of these readme's and delete the rest usually. What's the other ones? Oh, push. So the push command, a lot of times when I use a template, I want to update the template. And what you do is you go update your template in your cookie cutter folder. And then you might be running a couple, so you might have updated a few of them. And then you run a push. And then it pushes all of the changes. So you can change multiple templates. So the next time you use them, they'll have whatever useful things you added to them. Because every time I use a project template, I am building something and I want to add some features to the template usually, so that the next time they're there. So the whole thing grows. And I mean, I think I used a cookie cutter to make this project, and I might use multiple. I might use the readme, some things from snippets or cheat sheets or pieces of other apps. So sometimes I'll just throw a few projects together into one and then take what I need and clean it up. So it's part of the terminal workflow so that you can create your repo using multiple templates and then push them all. And then next time you make a new project, you can add your project as a template and use it in the next one. It just saves a bunch of time, and it just, any feature that you learn to make, you can just add it to your templates and reuse it the next time. I think that's everything. Here it is. It works. I think I have a lot of ideas and things that could be done to make it better. But that's all for now. Enjoy.